الخضر عليه السلام. You might know his name. All Muslims know about al-Khidr alayhi salam. He is famous for his incident with Musa, Kalimullah, peace be upon him. Al-Khidr alayhi salam has history here in this mosque. Al-Khidr alayhi salam, in this mosque here, he met the commander of the faithful, peace be upon him. Al-Khidr, it is narrated by Shaykh al-Saduq in his well-renowned book, Adl al-Shara'i. In the chapter where Shaykh al-Saduq speaks about the names and the meanings behind prophets, as well as in Shaykh al-Saduq's Ma'ani al-Akhbar through different chains of transmission. And I think that al-Saduq agrees with this khabar, this report. Shaykh al-Saduq narrates this hadith from Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, saying that al-Khidr was a prophet of the prophets of Allah, and that he had a message, a da'wah, to the Tawheed, to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that his name Khidr, the kunya, the nickname given to him, was because when al-Khidr used to stand on something that was dry, earth or dry wood, he would give it life. It would come back in life and turn green. When he walks on dry, yellow grass, he would turn it green. As well, there is another report by Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam that his companion asked him about al-Khidr and al-Qarnayn. Are they prophets? What are they? He said, no, we are like the companion of Musa alayhi salam and like the companion of al-Qarnayn, for example. That is the Nas of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. I'll read you the tradition exactly. The hadith goes, Ali alayhi salam is a muhaddith. Al-Harith ibn al-Mughira asked him, he said, so you say he was a prophet? He said, no. He moved his hand like this. Then he said, like the companion of Sulaiman or Moses or Dhul-Qarnayn alayhum as-salam. Basically, here we have two reports. These two reports, of course, they're clashing. One says that al-Khidr was a pious, honorable worshiper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other says, no, he was a prophet. And he had a message, and he's still living amongst us today. Either or, I narrated to you both reports, and there is ikhtilaf between the ulama, and it seems that Shaykh al-Saduq agreed with the khabar that he narrated about Imam al-Baqir salamullahi alayhi. Now I stated that al-Khidr alayhi salam has a story here in this mosque. What is his story? It is narrated in the Manaqib of Al Abi Talib by Ibn Shar Ashub. He narrates this incident of Al-Khidr alayhi salam. He narrates that Al-Khidr here in this beautiful mosque, Al-Khidr came. He was wearing a green jubba. He was wearing a imama and he had a cloth wrapped around him. Amir al-Mu'mineen used to pray somewhere in this area close to where his mihrab is, by the fifth and seventh pillar, as the narrations tell us. Amir al-Mu'mineen, the commander of the faithful, was praying. While he was praying, he finished praying, and this man came up to him, as the narration states. This man came up to him, and when al-Khidr saw this man, he stood by him. He stood by Amir al-Mu'mineen, peace be upon him, and he awaited until Imam Ali alayhi salam finished his prayer. When Imam Ali finished his prayer, the hadith says that he went down on his knees and he kissed the forehead of Imam Ali alayhi salam, peace be upon him. Ruhi lahu al-fida. Al-Khidr interacted with Amir al-Mu'mineen in this matter, this beautiful matter, here in this mosque right here. In these holy grounds, Al-Khidr interacted with Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Then Imam Ali alayhi salam took al-Khidr, exited the masjid. His companions followed and he told them, oh my companions, do you not know who that was? They said, we do not know, O commander of the faithful. He told them, that was my brother Khidr. He came to greet me. He came to greet me, and I took him outside and greeted him as well. and sent him on his way. You see, my dear brothers and sisters, this mosque has so much history. Al-Khudr and the way he interacted with Amir al-Mu'mineen is very beautiful. It shows you how much love Al-Khidr had for the commander of the faithful, for him to interact him in this way. Because Al-Khidr has a ma'rifa, he has a cognitive understanding of who Imam Ali is and who his maqam was. Unfortunately, unlike the people of Iraq, unlike the Muslimin in general, they did not give Imam Ali alayhi salam his due right. Instead, they oppressed him and they oppressed his family, and until today, his followers, his Shia, are oppressed. This here, in this mosque, we have Al-Khidr meeting Imam Ali alayhi salam. There is more in this mosque. This mosque has the Maqam of Ibrahim, of Noah, of Imam Sajjad, Imam Zain al-Abidin. This mosque has the place wherein the water gushed, like I said before. This mosque had the place of Beit al-Tasht. This mosque has the place of where Imam Ali's justice came true. Here, in this mosque, everything happened here. So much history. Now, inshallah, we finish narrating this story. We will move on, inshallah, and narrate to you another story, another interesting historical piece of this mosque. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam told them, no. They talked for a while. The snake, in one hadith, it says that the snake, the ground swallowed it up. In another narration, the snake left through the same door.